just open this up. I don't have much, much to say since the last time we spoke, since we haven't played. So whatever you guys got.
I think this is the first real up-tempo offense in your defense this year. The Capitol Hill plays obviously the kind of challenge that was represented for your defense, I think.
It can be. And I think Cal's an up-tempo offense. I think USC has a little more formations, so that can make it a little more challenging when they're getting lined up quickly. But, you know, the defense has seen it from quite a while in terms of practice, worked on those things. Now, games are always a little bit different, so that will be another element. The first element being the really good players that they have over there. And then they do a great job with their schemes, executing, and then you throw in a little tempo and stuff. It's a big, big challenge.
What did Stanford do well against them? Maybe Arizona State?
Yeah, you know, I think one thing is they kind of weathered the storm. You know, they hung in there with them. They got behind, but then they scored and they kind of answered, and you know, it just didn't get away from them. I mean, Arizona State, you know, by halftime, that was just a tough situation. They just had those. Fumble return and then fumble the kickoff and then, you know, the momentum just so I think, you know, Stanford just, you know, kept close, kept battling, and were able to do that. Now, credit to Stanford to be able to do that.
They look much like what you saw here in the 2013 opener.
They have, you know, some of the similar concepts, some of the similar plays. I think they're doing a little bit more. They have some two-back concepts as well, as not just all spread, and so there's a lot of variety there.
Jake's first portal game since the opener. Where would you say you've seen the biggest portal in terms of his passing specifics from that first game?
Yeah, you know, I think there's certain things that he's pretty dialed in, certain plays, certain concepts that we run. He's probably more dialed into and feels good with. But you know, as we go through this, we keep adding kind of more to his plate. And so that's the process of this whole year. You know, certain things that we're trying to get more reps with because he hasn't had them a whole lot. So again, it's that fine balance between, you know, flooding him, overloading him, and still being able to scheme things how we'd like to.
In your experience, Chris, is there a lot of value a guy in Jake's position can take for learning at Boise in the hospital environment? Everything else, take it on the road again?
I would hope so. I mean, I think noise is the big thing. I think noise is really the big thing. That's a hard thing to deal with. It's really, really loud at all times. And, you know, Boise was a good introduction to that because they get pretty loud there. And but we practice a lot with that. You know, it's part of our practice even when we're at home. You know, we put noise on, music on, all those things. And you know, I think halftime kids think I'm doing that to energize them and fire them up. I'm really doing it so they can't hear. And I think that helps us in the long run.
When you self-scout things like clapping and some of those things to kind of negate the noise factor, have you found that that's been fairly successful for eliminating false starts?
I think the big thing is being able to hear. Like, what's the best way to do that? Well, a silent count is probably the best way because you don't have to hear anything. But I think there's, you know, like everything, there's always a trade-off. There's no, like, perfect thing. There's no perfect plays. There's no way they can always answer. You know, when you're going on a silent count, one of the linemen is going to see things at the last second. You know, in our opinion, we got a couple different things.